The concern was first raised by Patrick Isanji, the chairperson budget committee, while presenting the report on the appropriation bill of 2023 budget estimates, where he revealed that Uganda's public debt stock increased from over 78.7 trillion shillings in 2021 to 2022 to 80.7 trillion shillings in the first half of 2022-2023 financial year.
Uganda's external debt is largely concessional. That is a cheaper debt as of now, about 75%. The share of non-concessional debt is on the rise. That means the lenders are tightening the lending policies and reviewing terms. So if we are to borrow now, we are most likely going to borrow at a very high interest rate. And that will raise our interest. And we have to be very cautious as a country to maintain a favorable debt interest ratio to tax.
However, the April 2023 State of the Economy report by the Bank of Uganda put Uganda's provisional total public debt stock as at the end of March 2023 at 86.3 trillion shillings, approximately 47.7% of the GDP. The budget committee recommended that borrowing should be limited to critical projects while minimizing the acquisition of debt on non-concessional terms.
So our negotiators must step up their act so that if we are borrowing, we borrow only on concessional. And if we are investing, we must invest where productivity, and we must ensure there is value addition so that we earn our own money. Not investing, borrowing and investing anyhow. So we have to be very conscious while investing.
The budget committee also raised concerns on the cost of debt servicing, pointing out that a total of 17.108 trillion shillings has been proposed for debt servicing obligations in the financial year 2023-2024, an increase of 2.102 trillion shillings from 15.005 trillion shillings approved in 2022-2023 financial year.
Fiscal discipline to minimize deviations from the projected paths set. To this end, government should ensure that over the medium term, borrowing is limited to critical projects while minimizing acquisition of debt on non-concessional terms.
Significant concerns were raised in the minority report read by Mwanga Chivumbi, the Butambala County Member of Parliament, revealed that government's domestic borrowing has significantly increased over the years, which has undermined the private sector, whereby the acquisition has become expensive to private sector actors.
The government said they will borrow 8.4 trillion. Now they come with a figure they are going to borrow 10. For external, they committed to borrow 10. For domestic, they've gone ahead and borrowed 11. And two things to note, right, Honorable Speaker. There is also a great inconsistency when you read the table with the level of concessional versus non-concessional loan. 0.9, which is 1.4 trillion of the total borrowed money, will be concessional. The rest of the money is non.
Although the Bank of Uganda placed Uganda's public debt at 86 trillion shillings in the 2022-2023 national budget, the Treasury operations has been allocated 18.747 trillion shillings, up from 16.799 trillion shillings. The entity was allocated to manage Uganda's public debt. Of these funds, 6.013 trillion shillings will go towards interest payment on public debt, while the rest, 12.733 trillion shillings, will go towards other items in debt refinancing. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.